In this video, we're going to talk about incinerators and how they factor in environmental management. G'day, Brett, how are you?
Very well, thank
you. Incinerators sounds interesting. I'm presuming we're talking about chucking things into a big fire at some level.
Yeah, we certainly are, but we're talking about different types of waste and how to get rid of them. We go from a medical waste incinerator, which is ideal for remote locations. Medical waste, we're talking about limbs.
Limbs?
Yes. Yeah, in a remote island or in a war situation, you know, if something happens medically, you've got to dispose of that because it can cause diseases.
Yeah, I imagine.
So a medical waste incinerator will burn at 1,000 degrees, which gets rid of all your furans and dioxins. So it's a very clean burn, and it destroys everything that it burns very cleanly.
Okay, so my mind is sort of full of that picture for a second, but let's talk about different industries that might have an incinerator requirement. Medical, obviously. What are some of the other situations?
Hospitals will have medical incinerators, but we also carry a smart ash incinerator, which is for general waste. Again, ideal for remote locations where getting rid of just normal day-to-day waste is a problem. You can't transport it, especially if you're on an island situation or a small village. So the general waste incinerator will burn everything at 650 degrees C, which again is a very clean, smoke-free burn.
Okay, so what sort of things are we chucking in? You don't have to be as specific as limbs, that's kind of already coming in. Are we talking, I want to say, syringes? Are we sort of talking, what sort of things?
Any clinical waste that comes from a hospital can be incinerated. So, from your, as you said, your syringes and all sorts of wrappings, anything.
Placenta. Is there any, can you put sort of, I want to say, chemical waste in this? I mean, or do the fumes cause a problem? How does that work?
No, chemical waste is a different thing. This is more of a clinical waste or general waste for incineration.
Okay, good. So you've spoken about the ash incinerator and you've spoken about the medical one. Are there any other big types we should know about?
No, they're the two main ones, because general waste and clinical waste are the two problem areas, especially in the Pacific Island areas and in remote Australia.
And we're talking about, I want to say, unused or overdue, out-of-date drugs and so forth as well?
Absolutely. We've got a drug terminator that fits on the smart ash, and it's ideal for getting rid of all types of narcotic drugs.
Going backwards just for a second, we're talking about incinerators here. We have been talking about, I want to say, environmental spills and so forth. This isn't so much for spills or things going wrong. This is for use generally over the course of time. This is like a sort of a standard day-to-day use sort of situation.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it's to help the environment. It's to get rid of our waste, which is a huge problem worldwide now.
Okay. So, Brett, I want to ask about, when I think of burning something, of course, I think of smoke. I think it'd be horrible and what have you. These temperatures are pretty high. What's the story with sort of the smoke output, but also the actual output at the end? There's got to be some ash or something. How much does this sort of reduce from this to that?
Okay, firstly, it's dual chambered, so it burns at a very high temperature, over 1,000 degrees, so it's a very clean burn. As I said, it gets rid of dioxins and furans, and it also reduces down to 5% volume. So if you're burning 30 kg, it only drops down to 5%, which is ash that can just go to your lawns or into your gardens because it's totally clean.
All right, terrific. Thank you so much. I appreciate your advice. For those of you who'd like to find out more or ask specific questions to do with your specific situation, please join us online through bulbeckenviro.com.au or just reach out, send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to answer your questions and help as much as we can.